Hi folks, John Hecker here again, the pro at Brooklyn Country Club in Rochester, New York. Today I'm going to take you through ball position. I haven't talked about that too much in the past, and I thought I'd cover some of the things that I see happen to my students that seem obvious to me when they come for lessons, and maybe they'll help tip you off on why your shot patterns are what they are. So I have Nick Watney here hitting an iron. You'll see that the irons are played pretty much in the middle of your stance, and the reason for that is the ball is actually on the ground. And irons are made to hit into the ground. You're made, they have a sharp leading edge. So you'll see Nick has his weight pretty much 50-50 in his stance. And that'll help him kind of hit the ball and then the ground, make a nice contact with the ball. If you have the ball too far forward in your stance with an iron, you will tend to have trouble hitting the ball solid. You will tend to pull the ball. If you do catch the ball with the loft of the club, it will go too high and too short. If you hit the leading edge, which we all know has no loft, you'll tend to hit skulls. Now, if you have the ball too far back in your stance, and when I say that, I'm really just moving it a couple inches there, you will tend to take too deep of a divot. Your ball will tend to start to the right too much. You will also tend to hook it too much. And it is, again, tough to make solid contact when you're in that position. Now with a driver, it's a little bit different. I'm gonna show you Louis Oosthuizen here. Louis obviously has the ball up near his left heel. That's the ideal position for a driver. You're trying to hit the ball. Tour player hits it from 1 degree up to 7 degrees up. Somewhere in there is a typical tour player. He's trying to launch it high, and they're trying to hit it a little bit on the upswing to hit the higher part of the club. The higher part of the loft, which actually gets less spin, so launching it high with low spin is your motivation there. And you can see his hands are actually behind the ball. He's set up very differently than, let's say, Nick Watney was, in the sense that he looks like he has more weight behind his ball than Nick Watney as they get you together. So you can see there's clearly a difference there. Now, if you play your driver too far back in your stance, you won't necessarily take a divot, but you'll get a glancing blow. You'll tend to hit it too low. You will tend to hook it too much. As I said, they won't feel good. Now, if you have the ball too far up in your stance, which I'll see people with it up outside of their front foot, again, the tendency is the opposite. You'll hit pulls. You'll hit slices. You'll hit the ball too high. You know, your driver will go 30 yards shorter than normal. It'll be tough to catch it solid. So knowing your ball position and practicing that is something that you'll find that you can really develop some consistencies with your shots. And sometimes I've got people with pretty nice swings who just don't understand their ball position. And by making the adjustments, they can really elevate their games. So give those things a try on the range. You put some clubs down between your legs, like I would here with Nick Watney, so that you practice the right ball position. Tinker with it. Play it a little further forward. See what you get. Play it a little further back. See what you get. See if those things develop different shots for you. And then you'll know how to make adjustments out on the course. So anyway, look forward to seeing you out playing soon and hope this helps.